Everybody, welcome back to Rote Reactions. I'm S.A. Baz Collins here with my illustrious co-host.
Hey, this is Albert Offlet.
Hey, so we are going to do a little rom-com or gay rom-com based on a book that neither Albert or I have read. So we know very little except what we saw in a trailer that we reacted to. And I'll put a link up here so people can go look at that reaction. But we really don't know what we're getting into. we'll just have to roll the dice and see. So you looking forward to it?
Oh my God, yeah. I have a couple of friends that like already watched it and they're like, have you watched it? And I'm like, not yet, don't tell me anything. So
yeah, I know. Yeah. I've already seen some reactions go up and I'm like, nope, not looking at all.
Yeah, all right. Can't wait.
Yeah, all right. So without further ado, you ready? Let's get going.
Yeah.
Future King of England, Prince Philip, Duke of Cambridge, married his childhood sweetheart, Lady Martha Fitzroy. Thousands came to cheer the couple and to cheer the prince's younger brother, Prince Henry, known affectionately as Prince of England's Hearts, and their younger sister, Princess Beatrice.
He's in another gay movie we need to watch at some point called Handsome Devil.
Oh, okay.
The charismatic son of the American president.
Hey, you've been yum all day. What's going on with you?
What's going on with this? Oh, you know who she is? I think she's the girl who played in Love, Victor.
I feel like if I use the wrong fork at dinner, they're just going to eat me alive.
Well, be American and use the wrong fork on purpose. Yeah, it is her. It is her.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Now, I did hear that there was supposed to be a sister of Alex, the American guy, but she's not in the movie. They've kind of combined her and his best friend into the character he's with now.
You're not going to want to hear this.
Ooh, cake.
No, he's such a snob.
I don't know, man. I was gonna go for a rich white boy. This is a rich white boy I'd go for.
But he's the worst kind of rich white boy. So smug and entitled.
He's a prince, Alex. He's literally entitled. Oh, you know.
How does he know?
Well, he's royalty.
Oh, that's a good point.
That screams entitlement.
He's very animated. He's the world's rudest person.
He's the world's most irritating person.
Also,
they've met.
I have heard so much about you. You're sticking with me tonight. Come on.
How's it going?
Really? Oh my God.
Okay. You know, I think that's kind of a twist, a wind up, because I don't think the royals would be that obvious about it.
Yeah.
I think if they just become icy, they don't really go and walk off, you know?
Uh-huh. So he's going to get totally completely drunk, or maybe he already. Yeah.
Yep.
Henry.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Probably not as many.
Oh, Jesus.
Rude. Tell me something.
Ooh, there we go.
Yes, Alex.
Oh, no.
Did your parents send you to snobbery school, or does looking down on people just come naturally to you? Well, in your case, I would say it's rather inevitable. We are the same height. Actually, it's your Royal Highness. Your Majesty is reserved for the King. Oh, thank you for the etiquette lesson. You're desperately in need of one. You know what?
Oh, no, he didn't. Really? Yeah, let's make it worse.
I love Nora. She's like slowly going under the table.
Oh, my God. I know everybody's looking. Oh, no.
Evidently, this was Nicholas's favorite scene to film. The blonde.
Oh my God. Oh, no. That thing's going to pop. Yeah. Oh no, the cake.
And evidently the cake was yummy, they said.
Oh, no. Darling, you've done some pretty stupid things in your day, but this...
takes the cake?
Oh, you hear that, Zara? He's opening with a joke. Maybe he can host the correspondence dinner next year.
Oh, no.
I sent you... mm-hmm. It's pretty simple instructions. Represent the family at the and don't cause an international incident.
Henry shoved me.
An urge I currently share with the prince. We have spent the last 3 years negotiating a new trade deal with His Majesty.
You know by next week no one will be talking about this anymore. And really, no reasonable person is going to even pay attention to
the
that
British
article,
okay?
The
deserve better from our current system. And it certainly casts a pall over our negotiations.
I'm on the ballot again in 14 months. What I need from you, sunshine of my heart.
Yeah, oh my God, the look.
Damage control. Zara will explain everything.
I'm really sorry, Mom.
I know you are, baby. That's why I need you to fix it.
Ah! All right.
Okay, but why does...
Oh my God, what the... Okay, Jesus, that wasn't...
To undo all the damage you've done, the White House and the palace are going to release a joint statement explaining that what happened at the wedding was a complete misunderstanding.
Yeah, which it was.
And despite rarely having time to see one another, you and Prince Henry are in fact close personal friends and have been for the last several years.
Zara.
This is a fact sheet on Prince Henry. Memorize it. And you are going there to work. No hookups, no partying.
Nice.
A camera, you better act like the sun shines out of his ass and you have a vitamin D deficiency.
Nope.
And there is no getting out of this.
As much as he complains, though, you can tell Alex is into Henry already. I mean, no one has that much of a...
What I want to know is, why does he not have an accent that matches his mother? I mean...
That is a good point.
If you're around it all the time from a child, I want to know what that story is.
Boarding school?
You're back in England so soon. No one is more mystified than I.
Oh.
So, what exactly is an equerry? Do you handle the horses? Or... personal attendant? Through the butler. I'm not the butler, I'm the equerry.
And back we go to my original question. What?
Here comes His Royal Highness now.
You've gotta be joking.
Alex, it's good to see you. Sober?
Yeah, no.
You're wearing lifts. Know that too, sweetheart. Are we finished here?
Yes, Your Royal Highness.
Ouch. And it's true. That's why he looks taller.
Hey, Sean, you think maybe I can get a little?
You're fine.
Thank you. Alex has very strong opinions, and he shares them loudly. What three words would I use to describe Henry? Blonde and British. One thing I most admire about Alex is his willingness to do when he's wrong. Wonderful.
Over to you.
You don't know this, but Henry has the best freestyle raps. Well,
come on, do a little for me.
No, that's not.
Well, this is awesome.
Voice of an angel, this one, really. I love hanging out with this guy. Which means that his mum outranks my mum. What do we think of that? You visit this place a lot? Every couple months. Never with photographers, though.
Stay down.
Whoa. Okay, there is no need for so many.
Yeah, that's way too overacted.
Yeah, it's.
Centile 33.
Yeah.
Makes sense. What do you mean by that?
But we do need, like, the awkward physical closeness. Oh. That's a good question.
Climate conference in Melbourne.
You're not that tight.
I went to introduce
introduced myself to you, and you looked at me like I had head lice. Then you turned to your equerry and said, get me out of here.
I didn't realize you'd heard that.
So you do admit that's a douchey thing to say.
Oh.
I could have been nicer.
You think?
Yeah, okay, so that's why.
Couldn't have just been the conference. Oh my God, it is. It is, isn't it?
Don't minimize it.
How could I possibly? It's already as minimal as it gets. Are you seriously telling me that one meeting years ago in which, yes, I admittedly acted ungenerously towards you, has occupied such a vast mental and emotional space in your head?
Sure, when you put it like that. But it was my first foray into the world as a public figure, and I was really scared, and you could have helped me, and you didn't.
Oh,
first impressions. I would just come back and say, protocol says first impressions are very important, and you really fucked up.
Yep.
That's how I would put it. Admitting when you're wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ooh, he did it. He did say it. I was a prick to you.
It's no excuse, but I was a prick to everyone in those days. My father had died a few months before, and the palace insisted on parading me around. Survived it. That means we never have to see each other again.
Wrong. You're expected at my New Year's party.
No, I hate New Year's.
Wow. Most people would kill to get an invite to my party.
That's perfect. You can kill me and I won't have to go.
Some photos, Your Royal Highness. Mr. Claremont, dear.
I think we're supposed to shake hands now. I know. Stand to your right. Okay.
Thank you very much.
Well, I need to get out of here. See you in a few months, Your Majesty. Later, Sean.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, mijo.
I watched your committee hearing on the flight home.
Yeah, you and three other people.
You should be tougher on those agribusiness mofos.
Well, maybe I can get you to push me a cake for me. What's your beef with him, anyway? I mean, he seems like a nice enough guy.
Oh, come on, Dad. He's elite and privileged and lives in a palace. What's that?
I'm just...
Excuse me?
Hey, you and Mom taught me to question authority.
Mm. Oh, thank you.
And privileged, and live in a palace. And your mom is the epitome of authority.
Not white.
Indeed.
Not fully.
Alex. That's something I don't understand about Alex, really. Like, why is he so resentful towards, like, the elite, if he belongs to it? Like,
how about sources close to the president?
I'm gonna...
Bueno, lo intenté. Deberíamos de vernos pronto. Off the record, of course. Hace mucho, no?
Yeah. Well, la escuela ha estado una locura.
Also, they were together.
Eso y las pestañas.
He does have pretty lashes.
Yeah.
Get going. Qué buena birthday, Miguel.
He has lashes girls would kill for. The girls on the next table. Oh, girl, I heard that.
Yeah. Yeah, with no chance. Yeah. Oh, he's not kidding. Okay.
He's her Herman's dickhead.
Nice. Okay, I have to object to, like, the package of chips on his desk. Like, I mean, come on. Really?
That's okay. I'm good with shade.
I hate the tie you're wearing in Vogue. It's so boring. What do you have against color anyway?
Gray is a color, thank you.
first read Zadie Smith as a teenager.
You absolutely have to read Another Country by James Baldwin.
The Picture of Dorian Gray.
And Love in the Time of Cholera.
Also, Madame Bovary.
I'm sending you a copy. That's the thing that people don't understand about Byron's poetry. He was single-handedly responsible for every romance ever written in the last two centuries. And that's not even considering his personal life.
I'm blocking you for the rest of the night.
Don't ask Mommy for a pet if you can't take care of it.
Why are you awake?
Because some bellend decided to call me at 3 a.m. to talk turkey.
What's a bellend?
Look it up. I'm also a
dickhead. World-class
insomniac. Never occurred to me that the royal family watches television.
Well, we all share the same password.
You're more of a human than I thought.
Wow, thank you, Alex. That is so flattering.
No, I just mean, you don't seem like the kind of person that would name their dog David.
He's named after Bowie.
Wait, seriously?
Hmm.
That's way cooler. Why not just call him Bowie then?
It's a bit on the nose, don't you think?
Have I surprised you in any way?
Nope. You are just as ghastly as I imagined.
I'm hanging up now.
No, I'm hanging up on you.
Fine. Have it your way. That's what the big red button is for.
Good night.
It's an inventive way to do conversations.
That was really well done. I liked it. The editing of the entire scene was really nice. It's also cool that actual time is passing, you know, for them to get to know each other better. It's not just like, oh my God, yeah, we're in love now or whatever.
Alex, this isn't a really good time. I have a ton of work. Can you just, yeah, just make yourself at home, kid.
Okay, here's the deal. I wrote a 14-page memo detailing how we can win in Texas next year. I spent weeks working on it. I think it's a viable plan that you should take seriously. I emailed it to senior campaign staff 3 weeks ago, and I've heard nada.
Did anyone ask you to write this memo?
No, I took the initiative.
Yeah, if there's one thing people on campaigns hate, it's when the candidate's family takes initiative.
Zara, there are good ideas in here. I really want to help.
You do help. You are genuinely useful.
Yeah, for like photo ops and New Year's parties and stupid shit like that. And I could be doing so much more. Will you please read my memo?
Fine.
Thank you.
Now get the hell out of my office.
Okay, girl. I see you. I was talking about Alec. No, I'm
kidding. Oh, look who it is. Nice tie. Rocking the orange.
Orange? Must be colorblind. This is obviously copper.
You are so annoying.
Nora, this is my best mate, Percy Conjure, who has been...
Aww.
Catch up. Oh, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Oh, my God. Oh, instant awkwardness. Okay. Oh. Wait, wait. So no one knows Alex is gay? He's dancing. That's progress. Okay, well, kinda. Oh, that's so cool. Wow, that was super cool. I liked that.
Okay, this Latino director knows what he's doing. Good for him.
Whoa, okay, ladies, slow down. Wow.
Yeah.
Oh no, and Henry thinks. Oh.
What are you doing out here?
Wanted to get some air.
Did I do something wrong?
Do you ever wonder who you'd be if you were an anonymous person in the world?
I was an anonymous working class kid for most of my life. And then my mom became president.
Oh. Yeah. American.
Who would you be? Be a writer.
Not a member of the firm.
Paris.
Ooh, a writer.
So, okay, so Prince Henry is one of our own.
Yeah. It's so hard for a prince to get a date. People I date don't interest me, and the people who interest me, I can't date.
Oh my God, Henry, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Christ, you're as thick as it gets.
He's not.
Yeah. Interesting that it was Prince Henry who actually kissed Alex.
We're now still out on the road with me to see what's happening in our Midwestern towns. Empty factories, hollowed out storefronts.
Wow, so total silence. I suppose he's freaking out.
I'm ready to lead from day one. And that's why I can deliver on my plan and bring prosperity. Prosperity!
Okay, what's going on?
So, funny thing happened on New Year's Eve. Henry kind of kissed me.
I told
He's going to tell her? Okay.
Some men would consider exquisite. So from where I'm sitting, Henry is
kind of gay.
More like the first 50 rows of a Gaga concert kind of gay.
But he's always dating a different girl.
Honey, aren't allowed to be gay. You should know that.
Did I forget your birthday?
Not yet.
Mm.
Do you remember Henry's friend, Percy?
Are you into him?
I'm not.
Oh, they hit it off.
Right now, I'm more into getting female identifying candidates elected to Congress, but he does have good taste in florists. Anyway, okay, tell me more about this kiss. Did you like it?
Aw.
Grabbed my hair in a way that made me understand the difference between rugby and football.
I'm gonna take that as a yes.
And it wasn't
okay, that's a weird way to put it.
I mean, you've been wanting him to dick you down forever.
What? Wrong! No, 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 no.
Okay. Excuse me?
Allow me to lay out some observations for you. Extrapolate as you wish. First, you've been, like, completely obsessed with Henry for years.
I've not
Do not interrupt me. You've been long-distance text flirting with him.
That is a good point.
You spent the entire New Year's party straight up ignoring the who's who of hot young women in order to talk to Henry. And he kissed you. And you liked it. So, objectively, what do you think that means?
I don't know.
She nailed ya.
I don't know. I don't know. Okay. Look.
Really? Really?
How many guys have you been with?
Whoa.
Awkward.
What was that about?
I mean, but they should have seen her come. Well, anyway.
Yeah, no. Glass cage?
Yeah.
Shut up!
Didn't see that coming.
Oh, just once.
defenses are much safer. Okay, well,
they do come with a retinue of guards. And that's me figuring out how to use the retinue in a conversation. I like all these sassy women around him. I really like that.
Yep. Very enjoyable dialogue all over them. Oh, God, nice dress.
Madam President? Alex? Perfect.
Oh, he didn't come.
Alex? Nice talks. Que guapo.
There we go. Thanks, you too.
I read your Texas campaign memo.
How? That was super confidential.
I'm a journalist, Alex. I quite literally have my sources. Anyway, I think you've got some good ideas.
Yeah, that was what I was going to ask.
Is this the year that...
Oh, there he is. Texas. He's been totally ignored.
Earth to Alex.
Yeah, Miguel, you're being upstaged by an actual prince.
Oh man, ouch.
Private.
Security team will taser you. So I'm guessing the son is bisexual.
Yeah.
I know I owe you an explanation. My behavior was appalling.
Shut up, stop talking.
Well, they definitely have chemistry.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Okay, really? Like...
So are you still...
They were having a conversation. It was a conversation. Really close, intimate conversation.
Like Stone.
Henry and I are much happier against walls.
Everything all right?
Yes, very excited to be here.
Hopefully we'll get through tonight without any more
scandals.
The night is young, Ma. Okay, here's what we're gonna do.
Yes, Tommy. We're gonna stay at least 500 feet away from you for the rest of the night.
Sensible plan.
I'm not done.
Of course you're not.
Then at midnight, you're gonna come to my room on the second floor of the residence where I'm going to do some very bad things to you.
I mean, he didn't say no.
Fancy you?
Melbourne Climate Conference.
First night party.
Wow.
You had a lot going on that night.
Tell me about it.
I really thought you hated me.
I hated how good you looked.
Yeah, something tells me Alex likes to be told how good he looks.
Yeah.
Just floating that out there.
Key to my family's house in Austin. I started wearing it when we moved here.
Yeah, I didn't.
Wow, he didn't even get undressed. I've owned a key
in my entire life.
Yeah, that's true.
Put it out there.
Yes.
I guess you could say I'm bisexual. Noted. Just to put it out there, I am as...
Right.
What? I have no idea what a maple is.
Right.
Are they known for their homosexual tendencies?
Oh God, yes. Notorious. Yeah. Notorious.
I wouldn't mind doing this again.
Me neither.
We just have to keep it very... casual, of course.
Oh, obviously, the
press and all. I just can't afford for you to fall in love with me.
Casual?
Get over yourself, your majesty.
It's your royal highness. I don't know how many times I have to tell you that.
All right. So he went right there. Okay.
If I remember right, in Handsome Devil, he has a really good singing voice.
Yeah.
Wow,
what a look.
They are very pretty.
Yeah, yeah. I kind of get the sense that Alex's character is meant to find emotional intimacy very difficult or something, but he kind of wants to, I don't know, try. Okay, this is another sport I know absolutely nothing about.
Which is weird because in Latin American countries further south, it gets played a lot.
For real?
Oh, yeah. In South America, it's huge.
Okay. Wow. Not, absolutely no idea. Okay. It looks very difficult, though. I mean, you have to manage the horse.
Someone's going to discover them. They think they're being safe, but yeah, they so aren't.
And they, yeah, I mean, so many people could walk in.
I can eat.
I think you already did. Just going
to
put
They're going to go to Paris.
He is.
Yelp review, 5 stars.
Oh, really?
Somebody likes the vitamin D.
That was very sweet.
Probably suspect my brother Philip is completely oblivious. And what about his majesty?
Oh no. Wow.
Grandpa's a cold-hard realist. He sat me down on my 18th birthday and told me not to let any selfish desires I might be harboring reflect poorly on the crown. That is some bullshit.
Yep, that's the firm.
It's my life. Doesn't mean you have to accept it.
Wow. That's tough.
Yeah, he kind of does.
When I realized that everyone in my country knew my name, but I would never know theirs. Prince Henry belongs to Britain. Henry Fox has to belong to himself, or else he'll vanish. Can he ever belong to someone else?
Wow. Oh. Can't you just like quit and say I'm done being a prince or what? Oh my god.
I think we should make love tonight. Oh. I mean, yeah. I'm down. But I mean, who says make love anymore? We're gonna like listen to Lana Del Rey when we do it?
All right.
It's just, who's gonna, because I've never, oh my god. I am so not playing this game right now. I went to an English boarding school, dear. Trust me, you're in good hands.
Okay, good to know about English boarding schools.
Yeah.
Serving up tea.
Oh, that was adorable.
I will say, this is Nicholas, who's playing Prince Henry. This is vastly different from the character he played in Handsome Devil, which was much more reserved. You always question, is he gay or is he not? You know, find out in the length of the movie that he is, but...
Okay.
It's a very, very different role for him,
mm.
which is good. I like seeing him in this light.
Mm.
And you have to, I guess one of the things you have we have to kind of take in is the fact that as a royal, you get so much in life handed to you, but mm-hmm. it comes at a tremendous cost. So this moment for Henry would be very, very special.
Yeah. Also for Alex, I think he projects so much confidence and everything, but then you can see that he gets nervous and there might even be some insecurity there because of...
Ooh.
Okay.
I think America's invading England. I'm...
Oh.
All our British fans, what do you think?
I can't believe how long it was about you.
America is storming the palace. They really do have a very, very good chemistry.
Yeah.
And it's obvious they've negotiated the intimacy part of the performance because you can tell they're on the same page. You know, there's no hesitancy. It plays well. And again, it's authentic. You know, I mean, so you're getting a much more realistic portrayal.
Oh. It's very sweet. The way that both of them are finally like letting down their walls and going like,
yeah, yeah, exactly. I think it's, and... yeah, it's equal for both.
Is there any part of you that wishes you weren't the son of a president? Or that your family wasn't in politics? I actually wish I could help more. It's gonna be a tough campaign. You really do love it, don't you? Yeah, I really do. To devote your life to helping others. To know that what you do has a meaningful impact on people's lives. I know it's my life's work. Is there any part of you that doubts? My father was 12 when my abuela brought him and his sister over from Mexico. You may not understand this, but in America, if you're an immigrant with a Z in your last name, there's not a lot of people in positions of power that look like you or sound like you.
It's changing.
Oh.
The browning of America, I'm telling you.
Something yeah.
that my father didn't see when he was growing up. You can't know what that means.
Well.
I'm learning.
What a great conversation from both their perspectives. Because Henry has been made to serve. I mean, that's what he's expected to do.
Mm-hmm.
And here's Alex who wants to do it, you know?
Closing time. The bums rush in melody, dear.